Assalamu alaikum. I am here with the next lecture, that is Animal Kingdom. Today I will discuss about Animal Kingdom. Okay, to understand Animal Kingdom, we have to understand what is animal. As you all know that animals are multicellular, means उनके पास एक सेल नहीं होता, दो या दो से ज़्यादा सेल से जो है एनिमल्स बनते हैं और वो हेटरोट्रॉफिक होते हैं. हेटरोट्रॉफिक ऑर्गेनिजम्स वो होते हैं जो अपना फूड खुद प्रिपेयर करने की सलाहियत नहीं रखते, वो दूसरी सोर्सेज से अपना फूड लेते हैं, जैसे प्लांट्स, एनिमल मैटर एंड ऑल. एंड सबसे मेजर एनिमल्स में ये भी फ़र्क होता है कि एनिमल्स के पास सेल वॉल और क्लोरोफिल नहीं होता, ये सिर्फ प्लांट्स के पास होता है. एनिमल्स के पास सिर्फ जो है सेल मेम्ब्रेन होती है. Now there are 11 major phylums of kingdom Animalia that are given, as you can see, Porifera, Cnidaria, Cetiophora, Platyhelminthes, Aeschylomyces, Annelida, Arthropoda, Mollusca, Echinodermata, Hemichordata and Chordata. Now we have to understand that what are the basis of classification, means किन वजूहत पे जो है हमने एनिमल्स की क्लासिफिकेशन की गई. लेवल्स ऑफ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, क्योंकि सबके जो है ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, मतलब हर किसी की बॉडी अलग तरीके से ऑर्गेनाइज हुई हुई होती है. बॉडी सिमेट्री, जर्मिनल एंड एम्ब्रियोनिक लेयर्स, एज वी विल डिस्कस दीज इन नेक्स्ट स्लाइड्स आल्सो. सीलोम इज़ द बॉडी कैविटी. मेटामेरिज्म इज़ द सेगमेंटेशन ऑफ द एनिमल्स बॉडी. नोटोकॉर्ड इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड अ स्केलेटन. Now, what are the levels of organization? There are four levels, that are cellular level, tissue level, organ level and organ system level of organization. Cellular level of organization is that in which cells are arranged as loose cells aggregates, मतलब वो tightly packed नहीं होते, loose cells होते हैं. इसमें जो है Porifera आता है, kingdom Porifera. phylum Porifera. And what is tissue level? In tissue level of organization, cells are arranged into tissues like Cnidaria and Cetiophora. Organ level of organizations are tissues are arranged into organs like higher animals, in this insects like Platyhelminthes, two chordates are come under the organ level of organization. In organ system level of organization, it is associated to organ system. Each system performs a physiological function, means they have organs like humans. In this class, higher animals are the examples. Organs of different animals show complexities, means they are different from each other. There are two types of digestive system found in animals, that is incomplete and complete. In incomplete digestive system, it has only a single opening that act as mouth and anus. It contains Cnidaria and Platyhelminthes. And the complete digestive system contains two separate openings of mouth and anus. Now the symmetry. Symmetry is the arrangement of similar body. It means when we cut into half, तो जो है अगर हम body को half में cut करें तो वो equal parts में divide हो तो वो symmetrical होती है, और अगर नहीं half में divide हो equal parts में तो वो asymmetrical होती है. The body that cannot be divided into two similar parts is called asymmetrical. In this, mostly poriferans and snails come under this example. And symmetrical body, as I told you, that it has been divided into two similar parts. अब symmetry की भी types होती हैं, that is radial symmetry and bilateral symmetry. Radial symmetry is that in which body is divided into two equal halves by any vertical plane along central axis, as you can see in this diagram also. In this, poriferans, cnidarians come. Bilateral symmetrical is the division of body into right and left halves in only one plane. In this, echinodermata and platyhelminthes to chordates comes. Now, the symmetry, the body of bilateral symmetrical animal has a dorsal upper side of animal body is called dorsal view, and the lower side of the animal body is called ventral. Left and right are lateral side, anterior just cephalic side, and posterior, or in which the posterior side is that in which tail comes. As you can see in this diagram, here all the labeling is done. Now, the animals also contain germinal layers. These layers of embryo from which all the body organs are formed. That's why these are called germinal layers. Here animals germinate. And it is of three types: ectoderm, endoderm, and mesoderm. Now, what are the classification of germinal layers? A diploblastic animals have two germinal layers, that is ectoderm and endoderm. In between these layers, an undifferentiated jelly-like layer is called mesoglia is present. It is nidaria or Sitenfora comes under this example. A diploblastic animals contain all the three layers, that is ectoderm, the middle one is the mesoderm, and the inner one layer is the endoderm. In this, platyhelminthes, two chordates are the examples. Coelom. Now, coelom is called the body cavity of animals, that how their body parts are arranged. It is the cavity lined by mesoderm. It is seen between body wall and gut wall. Coelom separates the muscle of gut and body wall. Now, there are also three types of coeloms of animals: acoelomate, cetocoelomate, and coelomate. Acoelomate means the animals don't possess the body cavity. The space between body wall and digestive cavity is filled with matrix parenchyma. Cetocoelomate is also called a false coelom. Here the body cavity is not lined by mesoderm. Mesoderm is scattered as pouches, as you can see in this diagram. केस में जो है ना मीजोडर्म जो है नज़र नहीं आती, फॉल्स होती है बस, वो पाउच की शक्ल में, एज यू कैन सी इन दिस डायग्राम, राउंड राउंड जो है नज़र आ रही है. नाउ सीलोमेट. हेयर सीलोम अराइजेस फ्रॉम मीजोडर्म, मतलब इधर जो है सीलोमेट प्रेजेंट है, एंड इट इज़ लाइन बाय पेरिटोनियल लेयर एंड फिल्ड विद सीलोमिक फ्लूड. एनिलिट्स एंड कॉर्डेट्स कम अंडर दिस एग्जाम्पल. As you can see, the space between body wall and digestive cavity is filled with matrix parenchyma. Here, the in pseudocoelomate, the body cavity is not lined with mesoderm, and in the coelomates, the coelom arises from mesoderm. Coelom is lined by peritoneal layer. In this diagram, it is explained very clearly. This is all. Thank you.